Carol Simpson.
Good evening. At Kennedy Space Center, disappointed NASA officials say it's anybody's guess when the Space Shuttle Atlantis will be able to take off and deploy a robot probe to study the planet Venus. It all depends on how quickly engineers can repair the mechanical problems that derailed yesterday's mission less than a minute before liftoff. The latest from Morton Dean.
The five crew members are heading back to home base Houston this weekend, leaving the Atlantis and its troubles to the problem solvers. Engineers and technicians will replace a leaky hydrogen line, and they have to decide what to do about a hydrogen pump, which apparently failed in the final seconds of Friday's countdown.
We don't know whether we get to change all three pumps or just one pump.
NASA says a new launch date won't be chosen before Monday at the earliest. Our best information is there won't be a launch until next Friday, but only the optimists are talking about Friday. The big worry concerns the Magellan space voyager sitting in the shuttle's cargo bay. The Magellan has to be sent on its way to Venus by May 28th, or it'll have to wait at least another 19 months for an opportunity to fly. It would be a serious blow to NASA's attempt to reinvigorate its science program. Morton Dean, ABC News, Kennedy Space Center, Florida.
Activists on both sides of the abortion issue were out in force today, hoping to catch the attention of the Supreme Court. The justices are now considering one of their most closely watched cases, one that could overturn the court's historic ruling legalizing abortion. Demonstrations took place in more than 60 cities across the nation, resulting in hundreds of arrests. The story from Steve Shepard.
In major cities across the country, demonstrators descended on specifically targeted medical clinics in an effort to stop abortions. The protesters, participating in what they called a National Day of Rescue, tried to physically block access to facilities where abortions are performed. They were resisted.
This is Dr. Gohari. I am the owner of the property. I would ask you to leave my property.
In Maryland and elsewhere, clinic operators were joined by thousands of pro-choice activists determined to keep clinics open. In Inglewood, California, those activists encouraged local police to make arrests.
Take them away! Take them away!
Police did. And according to the National Organization for Women, because of counter-demonstrators and efficient police work, anti-abortion protesters were unable to halt any scheduled abortions. At Reproductive Health Services in St. Louis, the plaintiff in the abortion rights case now pending before the Supreme Court, the doors remained open. By late this afternoon, however, both sides were claiming victory.
So there could be anywhere from 8,000 to 12,000 people right now risking arrest across this country to save children who are scheduled to be killed.
We are standing up for women's rights at clinic after clinic after clinic.
Anti-abortion activists are becoming bolder, using civil disobedience tactics honed during the civil rights movement. But as today's counter-demonstrations show, the pro-choice movement is adjusting to the change. Steve Shepard, ABC News, Washington.